This is the last of the seven stories of 2013, and I wrote it somewhere in October 2013, and I've entitled it Done With You. Here I am at the kitchen table writing a letter to you while you are sleeping in that bed you insisted that we purchase 43 years ago. 43 years minus 4 months ago, you came into our home with David, and after I had poured the tea in all three teacups, you took the teapot and quietly said, looking directly into my eyes, "Done. I'm done." Then, taking David's hand in yours, you walked to the door. Then you turned around, walked towards me, and took my hand, and placing your wedding band in the palm of my hand, you said, "I'm going to live with David now. I'll get all my stuff tomorrow." Then you folded my fingers of my hand around the ring. But you know all of that. What you may not know is how I reacted, so I'll tell you. I picked up the teacups and saucers one at a time, and I brought them to the kitchen, starting with David's teacup. I then washed each cup and plate slowly and patted the cups and saucers, starting with the ones that were for me, dry. Then I went to sleep. And when I woke up, I went for a walk. And I kept thinking that I should be reacting. But nothing was happening. Well, no, that's not completely true. Something did happen. Once. It happened when a thought came to me that I must tell the children. You remember our children, all four of them? What occurred, yeah? It did come to me that I should tell the children what occurred. But then another thought came to me. Why the hell should I tell the children? I didn't leave, he did. And so I never did tell the children. Each time they call, I simply told them that you were not there, and to contact you by your cell phone. They never heard from me what happened, and I know they did not hear from you because they would have told me. They never did tell me, and they always tell me things, always. Oh, I hear you stirring. Yeah, there you are stirring, in the bed. There you go, gritting your teeth. You'll be up soon. What to do, what to do. Last night I heard a knocking at the door. I went to the door and I opened it, and there you were. After 4 months, there you were at the door. And you told me that you were done with David, that it was something that happened, probably a middle life crisis, you said. What you did not know was that my mind was empty of you, my emotions empty of you, my spirit empty of you, but my body betrayed me. You gave me that look that only you can, and my body reached to your arms. This morning I lay in your arms waiting for the satisfaction, the comfort, the completeness my body has had from you for 43 years minus 4 months, and there was nothing, nothing. I lay in your arms empty. Slowly, I removed your arms wrapped around me and quietly left the bed. My body liked the distance. I checked everywhere, everywhere inside of me, and I now know that I am empty of you. So this is what I'm going to do. In a few minutes, I will put this letter in an envelope. And I will put the envelope on top of the fridge. And when you awake, I will make tea for two. And we will read the New York Times, share and laugh, as we have done for 43 years minus 4 months. Then when you have left, I will take the envelope off the fridge, change all the locks on all the doors, and nail this envelope with this letter inside to the front of the door. And when that is done, I will slip my wedding band of 43 years off my fingers, place it on the nail that is securing the envelope into the door, and write on the envelope in bright red ink for all to see these words: "Done with you." Then I will close the door, walk to the kitchen, and make a cup of tea for one.
So this concludes all seven stories. And again, just a reminder that any storytelling in any venue, as long as it's not for profit, and as long as there are no recording systems of any form of communication that duplicates what the teller is saying, as long as the storytellers inform who they're telling, that the story has been created by S.I. Boucaud, and spell the name Boucaud, which is B-O-U-C-A-U-D. In addition to informing the audience the title of the story prior to telling the story, do have the permission of S.I. Boucaud to tell once again Sound Rescue Truth, arriving at the Wii, the man with the hound dog face, driving on the rim of God's eyelashes, Jeep drivers in the passing, and the seventh one, which is the story entitled "Done With You." Those interested in duplicating the story for profit via any form of communication, or duplicating the story through a non-oral communication form, do not have the automatic permission to tell any of the stories that I have just listed. Those individuals are to contact S.I. Boucaud via email at boucaudinthestory7@gmail.com. So that's boucaudinthestory7, as in the number 7, at gmail.com. Comments are always welcome.